मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 8। इन लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑक्सिलरीज एंड मॉडल्स। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द यूजेस ऑफ मॉडल वर्ब्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी गेट कैन कुड नेम आइट। सो मेनी यूजेस ऑफ कैन कुड नेम आइट आर गिवन हियर। सो वन बाय वन वी विल टेक दीस यूजेस। एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल use of can and could, name and might. So you can see here first use of can. We use can to talk about ability. Here can is expressed to talk about ability. When we talk about ability, we use can. So here you can see the example. He can speak six languages. Means his ability is to speak six languages. So he can speak six languages means he is able to speak six languages. So he, that is his ability. So can is used to express ability. Second example, can you swim? So here in the second example, he can swim means his ability is to swim means he can swim. Or and then we use can to express ability. Can you swim? Means he is able to swim. Means his ability is here, there in him to swim. Means he can swim. Second example. Next use can refers to the present. Could is used to express the ability in the past. So can is used to express ability in present, and could is used to express past ability. So here example you can see, he could swim, could is used here. He could swim across the river when he was young. I just told the use of can to express present ability, and to express past ability, could is used. So could is the past tense of can. So here the example, he could swim when he was a child or he was young. He could swim means here we are talking about his ability, about his past. So in that way, in this way, we use could to express ability in the past. Third is that can and may are used for permission. Both can and may are used to take permission or to give permission. So may is formal, then can. Can is informal and may is formal. Generally we use may because that is formal. So here you can use my phone, or may I sit here, both are used to give permission or take permission. So here may is formal and can is informal, or both can and may are used to for permission. So you can use my phone and may I sit here. So here may is formal and can is informal. Next, number 4, use of could. Could is also used for permission. Can, could, may, might. For permission, we can use these models. So, could is also used for permission, but it is more polite than can. Could is more polite than can. So, could I use your phone? Could I ask you a personal question? So it is more polite than can. When we ask for permission, we use could to make our sentence more polite. We don't use can because that is not more polite, but could is polite, and to ask permission or to give permission, generally we use could to make our sentence more polite. Dear students, here are some more uses of can, could, may, might are given. So next use of can here, can and could. So we also use can and could to make request. Wherever we make request, we use can and could. Here could is more polite than can. So generally we should apply could because that is more polite than can. Examples are given here. Can I have a glass of water? And could I have some tea? So more polite. More politeness in a sentence. So, generally we use could to make request. Could I have some tea? Or can I have a glass of water? So, in both the sentences, could is more polite and we can use both can and could to make request. Next, we use may and might to talk about possibility in present and in present or future. So, whenever we talk about possibility, to express possibility, we use both may and might to in present and future. But here, what is the difference between may and might? May is for less strong possibility and might is for less possibility. Here, you can see the example. He might be at home now. So, he might be at home now in this sentence, there is the less possibility. And it may rain today. It may rain today in this sentence, there is more possibility. So, in this way, we can use may and might to express possibility in present and future. As I told, may for weak possibility and might is for weak possibility and may is for strong possibility. Next step number, you can see we also use could for possibility. Generally, may and might are used to express possibility, but sometimes we use could to express possibility. But what is the difference between among these models, may, might, can and could? So, could is used to express possibility less than may and might. It is less possibility. It expresses less possibility than may and might. Means, whenever we use could, it expresses less possibility than may and might. Means, could is used to express less possibility than may and might. You can see the example here. He could be at home now. So, that is whenever we apply could, it expresses less possibility. He could be at home now. And next is that, at number, may is used to express wish. May God bless you. May success attend you. May God be with you. So, in this way, we use may to express wish. Dear students, here some more uses of model verbs or model adjectives are given. So, at the number, could and might refer to the past time. Here, these are the past. These expresses the past of could expresses past of can and might expresses past of may. So, these could and might refer to the past. Here, you can see the example. He said that I might use his phone. So he said means in this sentence we can see that this is the discussion about past. So he said that I might use his phone. So they are talking about the past. Ki usne mujhse kaha ki main uska phone use kar sakta tha. Second example, I asked whether I could sit there. In this sentence, I asked whether I could sit there. So, could is also the past of can. Here in this sentence, I asked, maine usse pucha ki main yahan baith sakta hu ya nahi. Baith sakta tha ya nahi. In the third sentence, I was told that he might be at home at that time. So, in this sentence, I was told, mujhe kaha gaya tha, ki he might be at home at that time. Us time par ghar mein honge. And next, use of might to express assumption or supposition in past. Whenever we assume about past In that case, we use might, but we use might with have and past participle. So you can see the structure. First of all, the subject, and then the use of might. Might is here, have, and then past participle means third form of the verb. Here you can see the example. She might have gone to the office. She might have gone to the office. She is the subject. Might, that is the past form of the came, of came, have, and past participle go, went, gone. Gone is the past participle. In the next sentence, they might have reached there. वो वहां पहुंच गए होंगे. This is the past tense context of assumption and supposition of might. And she might have gone to the office. वो ऑफिस पहुंच गई होगी. So this is the assumption or supposition. Here we suppose or assume about past. And in place of might, you can use would. So she would have gone to the office. If you use would in place of might, you can make the sentence. She would have gone to the office and they would have reached there. So in this way, you can make the sentence of assumption and supposition in the past using might and would.